And don't move for 14 minutes. First of all, I offer my sastang dandavat puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands of times, at the lotus feet of my holy master, my supremely worshipable spiritual Gurudev, Asmadeya Paramaradatam Guru Parapadma, Nitila Pravisht Om Vishnupa, Ashtodarast Shishma Drupa Nugacharyava, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj.
Ofrece sus respetos al maestro espiritual.
You have to speak up so they can hear.
Sí, es que what a problem with remembering the proper name. The names. Only with names.
I am taking my heart like a handful of flowers and I am offering them at the feet of my spiritual.
Cojo mi corazón como un racimo de flores y lo pongo a los pies de mi maestro espiritual. Los pies del otro mi maestro espiritual.
Secondly, I bow down thousands of times at the feet of my guru's guru and his guru and his guru and all the great masters in our unbroken line of spiritual masters going back thousands of years to see Krishna himself.
Ofrezco mis respetos a toda la línea discipular de Krishna y de los maestros espirituales desde Krishna hasta mi maestro espiritual.
What I'm telling exactly tell to my guru and then to his guru and then to his guru like that. Only what I'm telling tell.
Ofrezco mis respetos a mi guru, mi maestro espiritual, al maestro de mi guru espiritual y al maestro de mi maestro espiritual, de mi guru espiritual.
So I'm remembering them because.
Los recuerdo porque.
Whatever I have in my life, they are very carefully passed down from generation to generation to me.
Todo lo que tengo en mi vida ha sido transmitido muy cuidadosamente hasta mí.
Like. A ripe fruit on a tree, if it will just fall and hit the ground, it will be broken.
Si la fruta madura cayera del árbol al suelo, quedaría rota.
But if someone will climb the tree and pick and then pass it to his friend, and he can pass it to his friend, he can give it to me perfectly.
Pero si un amigo mío coge la fruta del árbol y me la entrega, pasa a otro amigo y ese amigo me la entrega, entonces puedo comer la fruta adecuadamente.
So there's very delicious fruit.
Hay una fruta muy deliciosa.
That is called Krishna Prem, love for God.
Que se llama Krishna Prem, amor por Dios.
And in ancient times, our ancient spiritual masters, they bought this fruit from the spiritual world and they passed it down generation to generation and it's coming to us today.
Desde el mundo espiritual nuestros maestros subieron al mundo espiritual y trajeron del mundo espiritual estos frutos que han pasado de un maestro a otro maestro hasta nuestros días.
One great saint. His name is Raghunath Das Goswami.
Raghunath Das Goswami, un gran santo.
He has written a short poem called Sri Mana Shiksha.
Escribió un poema breve llamado Mana Shiksha.
It means instructions to my own mind.
Significa instrucciones para mi propia mente.
Because he has great humility.
Porque él tiene gran humildad.
He's not thinking I'm qualified to teach others.
Él no piensa estoy cualificado para enseñar a los demás.
So I should give instructions to my own foolish mind.
Por tanto, debería dar instrucciones a mi propia alocada mente.
In the Bhagavad Gita, see, Krishna has said, the mind is your worst enemy.
En el Bhagavad Gita se dice que tu mente es tu peor enemigo.
Enemy is a person who is making a plan how to ruin you.
Un enemigo es alguien que hace un plan para arruinarte.
If there's a country which has enmity with another country, then they have their intelligence department. It's working 24 hours a day to discover how to ruin the other country.
Cuando en un país se lleva mal con otro país, el departamento de inteligencia está averiguando cómo arruinar la vida del otro país. 24 horas al día.
This is what it means, enemy.
Eso es lo que significa enemigo.
So you should know that your own mind is your enemy and 24 hours a day working to bring your soul down.
Y deberíais de saber que la mente es tu enemigo que trabaja durante 24 horas para bajarte,
desmoronarte mentalmente.
Desmoronarte o bajar.
Yes. the mind is actually not you.
La mente no es en realidad, tú no eres en realidad la mente.
You are Atma, the soul.
Tú eres el alma.
Pure transcendental consciousness.
Eres una conciencia trascendental.
And that soul is now covered by two bodies.
Ese alma está cubierta por dos cuerpos.
The gross physical body.
El cuerpo grueso, el cuerpo burdo.
And the subtle psychological body, the mind.
Y el cuerpo sutil psicológico, la mente psicológica.
So the psychological body is inherently, by nature, a substance which is indifferent to God.
La mente psicológica es por naturaleza diferente a Dios.
No, es sustancialmente indiferente a Dios.
En su esencia.
Ah, indiferente a Dios.
Yeah. In the material mind, there's no inclination of spontaneous affection to God.
En la mente material no hay un sentimiento de amor espontáneo por Dios.
The mind is only filled with impressions of worldly enjoyment and attachments.
La mente solamente está llena de impresiones de cosas de apegos materiales.
So, as long as your consciousness is absorbed in the chattering, the echoes of the material mind, then you cannot be God conscious.
Si tú te quedas absorto por las cosas materiales, no puedes ser consciente de Dios.
Therefore, mantra is necessary.
Por esa razón, el mantra es necesario.
Man means mind and tra means deliver. That which delivers your consciousness from the confines or the imprisonment of the material mind is called mantra.
Man es mente y tra es deliver, entregar. Entonces,
liberar,
sí. Liberar la mente para
from the confines.
De la prisión de los apegos materiales.
Yes. So, when we are absorbed in singing the mantra, the holy names of Krishna, at that time the consciousness becomes free from the control of the mind.
Cuando nos desapegamos de las cosas materiales, nuestra mente se libera y puede cantar.
De los confines de la mente.
Puede cantar el mantra. Cuando cantas el mantra, te liberas de los confinamientos de la mente.
Now the soul can express, "Oh my Lord, I am your servant. Please accept me."
Entonces el alma puede decir, "Oh Señor, soy tu sirviente, por favor, ayúdame."
Acéptame.
And the soul, by nature, also, it does not have the love for God.
Y el alma, por naturaleza, tampoco posee amor por Dios.
That love is a gift.
Ese amor es un regalo, un don.
It is divine energy.
Es energía divina.
But that energy is in the mantra.
Pero esa energía está en el mantra.
So when you chant Hare Krishna.
Cuando cantas Hare Krishna.
Hare
Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Now Namakari Bahudha Nija Sara Shakti. All the energies of love are present in the holy name, and that love will come and fill your heart completely.
Todas las energías del amor están en el santo nombre, y ellas llenarán tu corazón
completa.
So, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, he said.
Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, él dijo.
Asat chista kasta prada prakatapasha libriha prakamam kama prakata patapati vyatikare gale badwa hange han iti bakavid vapagane krutvam futkaram mavati setatam mana ita. The meaning is that, oh my dear mind.
El significado es, oh querida mente.
My soul is on a journey.
Mi alma está en un viaje.
On a path, that is the spiritual path.
En un camino, en un sendero que es el sendero espiritual.
But as I was traveling on that path of spiritual life, there were some thieves, some dacoits hiding in the bushes.
Pero mientras iba por este sendero espiritual, surgieron unos ladrones.
Dacoits.
Dacoits.
Ladrones. You have this word in Spanish, dacoits?
Ladrones.
Ladrones. Gangsters.
Gangsters.
Bandits, yes.
Bandidos.
So they were hiding. And I was walking along on the path of spiritual life, and suddenly they jumped out and put a rope around my neck.
De repente estos bandidos me cogieron, me apresaron y me pusieron una cuerda alrededor del cuello.
And they started to strangle me and beat me.
Y empezaron a estrangularme y a golpearme.
Now what shall I do?
¿Y ahora qué hago?
What does it mean?
¿Qué significa?
That when you start to make progress on the path of your spiritual life,
cuando empiezas a progresar en el sendero de la vida
espiritual, then lust, anger, greed, envy, pride, illusion, all of these things, they will suddenly, you did not know they were there, actually, living inside your heart, they all jump out and try to catch you.
La lujuria, el orgullo, la envidia,
la ira,
todos estos sentidos que tú no sabías que estaban ahí, de repente saltan.
Te saltan encima y te atacan.
If you are just living ordinary material life, then you may not notice what is hiding there in your subconscious.
Cuando vives una vida material normal, no te das cuenta de lo que subyace en el subconsciente.
But when you try to become free from the limitations of the material mind, suddenly you discover.
Pero cuando tratas de liberarte de esta vida normal, entonces sale.
Many very bad qualities are there.
Muy malas cualidades, muchas.
And they jump out and try to catch you, strangle you.
Saltan y tratan de estrangularte.
So this is the nature of the spiritual progress. It's unavoidable. You say, oh, this will not happen to me. No, it's already happened.
Esta es la naturaleza del camino espiritual. No puedes evitarlo.
Yes.
Estas cosas pasan.
Estas cosas pasan.
So then we have to know what to do, and what to expect and what to do.
Entonces tenemos que saber qué hacer, qué esperar, qué podemos hacer.
So, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami is saying that at that time you should call out to your spiritual master.
Srila Raghunath Das Goswami dijo que debes de gritar pidiéndole ayuda a tu maestro espiritual.
And to his guru and all the great saints.
A su guru y a todos los grandes santos.
Don't think that the saints who have walked this path of pure bhakti before have died.
No penséis que todos estos santos que han ido por el sendero del bhakti antes han muerto.
If they have died, then bhakti doesn't work.
Si han muerto, el bhakti no funciona.
But pure devotion to God brings about for that soul a pure eternal spiritual body.
Esta vida espiritual te trae un cuerpo espiritual eterno.
That is for the ordinary person. What to speak of great saints who themselves have been sent from by Sri Krishna, the Supreme Lord, to this world to help us.
Eso es lo referente a la gente ordinaria. Pero qué decir de los santos que han ido descendiendo para ayudarnos a este mundo.
So we call their names. Oh, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
Oh, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
Oh, Rupa Goswami.
Oh, Rupa Goswami.
Oh, Gurudev!
Oh, Gurudev!
That one
you
know. And then, by their mercy will come.
Entonces su misericordia vendrá.
We remember their life
recordamos su, no, su vida.
And their teachings and their example.
Sus enseñanzas y su ejemplo.
And we try to become the embodiment of their conception.
Y intentamos ser la encarnación de ese concepto.
We try to make our heart one with their hearts.
Intentamos hacer nuestro corazón uno con su corazón.
Then your heart will become very cool and peaceful, undisturbed.
Entonces nuestro corazón se volverá fresco, tranquilo,
sin perturbación.
Sin perturbación.
So a proud person cannot make progress in spiritual life because they think they can do everything by themselves without the mercy of their guru and the saints.
Una persona orgullosa no puede conseguir estas cosas porque creen que pueden hacerlo por su propia cuenta sin la ayuda del guru.
Have you heard once there was a warrior named Karna?
Una vez hubo una persona,
un guerrero llamado Karna.
Karna. He was thinking.
Él pensaba.
I can fight with Arjuna.
Puedo pelear con Arjuna.
And Bhishma, very great warriors.
Y Bhishma, guerreros muy importantes.
So one day his friend came to him.
Un día un amigo vino a él.
His friend's name was Shalva.
El nombre del amigo se llama Shalva.
He said, "My dear friend."
Dijo, mi querido amigo.
I want to tell you one story.
Quiero contarte una historia.
Once there was a businessman.
Una vez hubo un hombre de negocios.
He was very wealthy.
Era muy rico.
And he lived in a city where there was a very pious king.
Y vivía en una ciudad donde había un rey muy piadoso.
So he was very safe and secure.
Él se sentía muy seguro y muy seguro.
So his family, he had a big family.
Tenía una gran familia.
And they used to eat very expensive food.
Comían alimentos muy caros.
And there was so much food they couldn't even eat it all.
Tenían tantos alimentos que no podían comérselo todo.
So they used to throw so much away.
Así que tiraban los alimentos que sobrantes.
So in that area there lived a crow.
En esa área vivía
un cuervo.
Cuervo.
A dirty, black, scraggly crow.
Un cuervo negro y
apestoso.
Feo y apestoso.
So this crow, he was flying over and he saw a big pile of food they have thrown out.
Este cuervo iba volando y vio una gran pila de alimento que se había tirado.
Feast time!
Festín!
So he was eating all the very expensive and delicious foods.
Y empezó a comerse todos los alimentos caros y deliciosos.
You know, because usually the crows, they go into the trash and just find some scraps.
No, normalmente los cuervos se alimentan de basura.
He was eating so much every day,
comía
and not ordinary, like a king, this crow.
Comía como un rey.
And he became strong.
Y se puso muy fuerte.
And he became very proud.
Y se volvió muy orgulloso.
When he saw any other crows, he was thinking, ah, they are nothing.
Cuando veía otros cuervos, decía, va, no sois nada.
I'm the king of the crows.
Soy el rey de los cuervos.
Not only the crows.
No solo de los cuervos.
All the birds.
De todos los pájaros.
So then one day.
Un día.
Some of the children of this rich man, they were playing in the garden.
Unos hijos de este hombre rico estaban jugando en el jardín.
And the crow was there.
Y el cuervo estaba allí.
And some beautiful swans who were migrating.
Y unos cisnes iban emigrando.
Unos preciosos cisnes.
Unos preciosos cisnes.
They also landed in that garden.
También aterrizaron en ese jardín.
So they were flying very long distance. They're on their way to Manas Sarovar.
Iban recorriendo unas grandes distancias hasta Manasarovar.
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 Is in the Himalayas, very high in the Himalayas.
Muy alto en los Himalayas está este lugar.
So it said that the Rajahansa swans, the kings of swans, they go there for their mating season.
el rey de los cisnes va allí para la reunión.
No, la temporada de apareamiento.
Ah, la temporada de apareamiento.
Yes. And to get there, they fly over oceans, thousands of miles.
Y para llegar allí recorrieron muchos océanos, muchas millas.
So, the children of that wealthy merchant, they went up to that crow. I said, "Hey, crow."
Los niños se acercaron al cuervo y le dijeron, "Hola, cuervo."
You look like the king of the birds.
Tú pareces el rey de los pájaros.
I said, "Very intelligent children."
Muy inteligentes.
If anyone will tell us what we want to hear, then we love them so much.
Sí.
Si alguien nos dice lo que queremos oír, nos encanta.
But if someone tells something, even if it's true, but we don't want to hear it, then.
Pero si alguien nos dice algo que es verdad, nosotros no queremos oírlo. No nos cae bien.
So they said, "We think that you can fly better than these swans."
Nosotros pensamos que tu cuervo puedes volar mejor que estos cisnes.
The crow was thinking, "Yes, I can."
El cuervo dijo, "Sí, puedo."
And he became so puffed up, he flew over to the swans.
Y se volvió tan orgulloso que voló con
with some of his crow friends.
Y voló junto con los otros cuervos al lado de los cisnes.
And he challenged the swans.
Y retó a los cisnes.
He said, "I challenge you to a flying contest."
Os reto a una competición de volar.
"I can fly much better than you."
Yo puedo volar mejor que vosotros.
"I can fly slowly, I can go quickly."
Puedo volar lento, puedo volar muy rápido.
"I can go like this, down and up again."
Puedo volar hacia abajo, hacia arriba otra vez.
"I can fly backwards."
Puedo volar hacia atrás.
"I can do loops."
Puedo hacer bucles.
So I challenge you to a flying contest.
Así que os reto a volar.
Then one swan, he said, "Well, I only know one style of flying."
Un cisne dijo, "Bueno, yo solo conozco una forma de volar."
"But I have a purpose and destination."
Pero yo tengo un propósito y un destino.
So then the swan took off.
Entonces el cisne despegó.
And very gracefully and slowly he was gliding through the sky.
Y con mucha gracia, con mucha belleza, se puso a volar majestuosamente por el cielo.
The crow said, "Ah, this is nothing. I can fly in 101 different ways."
Oh, eso no es nada. Yo puedo volar de 100 formas diferentes.
So the swan was flying very gracefully in one direction, and the crow was going whoosh, whoosh, up and down and backwards and round and round.
Entonces el cisne, que volaba majestuosamente en su dirección, vio como el cuervo volaba para arriba, para abajo, en una dirección, hacia adelante, hacia atrás.
And his friends were saying, "Ca, ca, ca."
Y los amigos le decían, "Ca, ca, ca."
Just see, our friend is the best.
Fíjate, nuestro amigo es el mejor.
Then suddenly, the swans, they turn to the west.
Entonces de repente los cisnes giran hacia el oeste.
And they left the land and began to fly over the ocean.
Y dejaron, abandonaron la tierra y empezaron a volar sobre el océano.
So the crow was trying to follow them.
Y el cuervo intentó seguirlos.
But he was running out of energy.
Pero le faltaba, se estaba quedando sin energías.
After some time, he looked around and he couldn't even see the land.
Al cabo de un tiempo, miró hacia atrás y vio que no veía la tierra.
Then he was thinking, "Oh my God."
Y pensó, "Oh Dios mío."
"I'm feeling tired."
Me siento cansado.
"And there's nowhere to land."
Y no tengo dónde posarme.
"If I land in the water, it's full of sharks and different dangerous creatures will eat me."
Si me poso sobre el agua, hay tiburones y otras criaturas que me pueden comer.
So he tried to keep going.
Intentó mantenerse volando.
And he was hoping that soon land would come on the other side.
Y esperó que pronto encontraría tierra firme.
But after an hour, still, now in all directions there was no land anywhere.
pero al cabo de un tiempo en ninguna dirección se veía por ningún lado tierra.
And his altitude was going down.
Y su altura fue reduciéndose, bajando.
Now he was just about staying above the water, and sometimes going in the water also.
Ahora se encontraba muy cerca del agua, a veces caía al agua.
The swan said, "What style of flying is this you're doing now?" Of the 101 styles, what style is this you keep eating the water?
Y ahora, ¿en qué? ¿Cómo es la forma que tú estás utilizando para volar? Tocando el agua es una de las muchas formas que tú usas para volar.
So then, finally, the crow realized, "Oh, I am not like that swan."
Entonces el cuervo se dio cuenta, yo no soy como ese cisne.
Now he will, for days and weeks, he will keep going and come to his destination.
Porque él seguiría volando durante días y semanas para llegar a su destino.
And just now, I am any minute now I'm finished.
Y en cualquier momento me muero.
And the crow fell in the water.
Y el cuervo cayó al agua.
And he cried out, "Help me, help me!"
El cuervo gritó, "Ayuda, ayuda!"
Then the swan was very compassionate.
El cisne era muy compasivo.
And he flew down and he took the crow on his back.
Y bajó, descendió hasta el cuervo y lo montó en su lomo.
And he took off and then he brought the crow back. He was flying back to the land.
Y con el cuervo en el lomo volvió a tierra, lo devolvió a tierra.
And the crow said, "I was eating this very opulent food of this wealthy family."
El cuervo le dijo, estaba comiendo estos alimentos caros de esta familia tan rica.
And in my mind, I began to think I'm a very great personality.
Y en mi mente,
I can do anything.
En mi mente pensé que yo era una gran personalidad y que podía hacer cualquier cosa.
But now I realize I'm just a dirty crow.
Pero ahora me he dado cuenta de que soy simplemente un sucio cuervo.
And I am very grateful to you that you have picked me up and saved my life.
Y me siento muy agradecido de que me has recogido y me has salvado la vida.
And the swan put him back on the land.
Y el cisne lo posó sobre la tierra.
So Shalva, he said to Karna, "Hey Karna, you are like that."
Shalva, el amigo, le dijo a Karna, "Tú eres como él."
You've been eating very delicious food in the palace of the Kauravas.
Tú has estado comiendo alimentos muy caros en el palacio de los Kauravas.
Now you think you can fight with Arjuna.
Y ahora te crees que puedes pelear con Arjuna.
So, our spiritual life is similar to that also.
Nuestra vida espiritual es similar a eso también.
When we have a good health,
cuando tenemos salud, buena salud,
then we say, "I can do anything."
Dices, puedo hacer cualquier cosa.
But then when you actually come to walk on the path of spiritual life, then you discover that it's not so easy.
Pero cuando te diriges al sendero espiritual, iniciar el sendero espiritual, entonces te das cuenta de que no es tan fácil.
And by our own strength, by our own capabilities, actually, we cannot be successful.
Y por nuestra propia fuerza, por nuestras propias capacidades, no podemos hacerlo.
Because our soul is anu, atomic, very small and very weak.
Porque nuestra alma es anu, atómica, muy pequeña y muy débil.
And maya, the illusory material energy, is vast like an ocean.
Y maya, la energía ilusoria material, es grande como el océano.
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Sri Krishna said, "Daiviya shaguna mayi, mama maya duratya, mama eva ye prapadyante maya me itam tarantite." This material energy of mine is very, very difficult to overcome.
En el Bhagavad Gita dice Krishna, esta maya, esta energía mía material es muy difícil de superar, de vencer.
But those who become humble and they surrender themselves to me, then they can easily cross through.
Pero aquellos que se hacen humildes y me sirven a mí, ellos pueden fácilmente superarlo.
So Srila Raghunath Das Goswami is giving us some advice.
Raghunath Das Goswami nos da un consejo.
Don't rely on your own power and your own strength.
No confíes en tu propio poder, en tu propia fuerza.
Don't rely on your contaminated mind and very little, limited material intelligence.
No confíes en tu limitada mente y en tu muy limitada inteligencia.
Material. Always remember your spiritual master and his guru and his guru and all the great teachers in our parampara, and by absorbing your mind in remembering them, then they will inspire you to follow in their footsteps.
Así pues, recuerda o piensa siempre en tu guru, en el guru de tu guru, en toda la línea discipular del parampara, y
they will inspire you.
Y ellos te inspirarán
how to follow in their footsteps.
Y ellos te inspirarán cómo seguir sus pasos.
Don't try to make your own path.
No intentes hacer tu propio sendero.
Because you'll be disconnected from that grace, that flow of grace which is coming in the Guru Parampara.
Porque te sentirás desconectado o estarás desconectado de su gracia, de esa gracia que se transmite en la línea discipular Parampara.
It's very difficult to control the mind.
Es muy difícil controlar la mente.
And even if the mind is fully controlled, still there's no guarantee that you can have a vision of Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Incluso si llegas a controlar completamente la mente, tampoco hay garantía de que puedas ver a Krishna.
Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, in another verse, he said, Yadhyatnatar samadamatma viveka yoga adhyatma lagnam avikarna abun manome rupasya tatsmita mukam sadayava lokam asadya madhyati harascharita idani. The meaning is,
Srila Raghunatha in un verso dijo,
my guru Rupa Goswami, he tried again and again to help me.
Mi guru Rupa Goswami intentó una y otra vez ayudarme.
He told me, sit like this, chant like this, pray like this.
Me dijo, siéntate así, canta así y reza así.
Discriminate between matter and spirit.
Discrimina entre materia y espíritu.
Or tolerate all difficulties.
Tolera todas las dificultades.
Gradually, by his daily guidance and daily training, then he taught me how to have sama dhamma, that means peaceful mind and peaceful senses.
Y de forma gradual me enseñó a conseguir una mente pacífica y unos sentidos pacíficos.
So the senses get their power from prana.
Los sentidos obtienen la energía del prana.
And this prana is interwoven with the fabric of your mind.
Y este prana está entretejido con la tela de la mente.
So if the senses are not controlled, then the mind becomes very turbulent.
Entonces, si la mente no está controlada, los sentidos no están controlados, la mente se vuelve muy turbulenta.
You cannot drink and party on Saturday and then go to church on Sunday.
No puedes beber y ir a un party en sábado y luego ir a la iglesia en domingo.
Doesn't work like that.
No funciona así.
Because the same energy, the prana, which is the causing the function of all your senses, that is interwoven with your mind. When you use the senses for the worldly pleasures, then the mind becomes completely disturbed.
Porque el prana está entreteje los sentidos con la mente y entonces te vuelves completamente
perturbado.
So the unstable mind cannot understand God.
La mente inestable no puede comprender a Dios.
The unstable mind cannot even give you the subjective intuition that you are not this physical body.
La mente no puede darte la intuición subjetiva de que tú eres el que tú no eres este cuerpo.
As long as the mind is oscillating with so many thoughts and desires, then you will always feel that you are this flesh.
Siempre que tu mente esté oscilando, siempre vas a pensar que tú eres este cuerpo, esta carne.
So, yadhyatmata samadhamatma viveka yoga. My teacher taught me how to control my senses and mind and develop a atma vivek yoga. That is the power to discriminate between myself, the soul, and the flesh.
Mi maestro me enseñó a discriminar entre...
Me enseñó el sendero para finalmente poder discriminar entre lo que es... No solamente se me enseñó el camino, sino también que yo pudiera aprender por mí mismo a discriminar entre lo que es el alma y la carne.
So by sama and dhamma, the control of the senses and control of the mind, then after that, the discrimination between matter and spirit arises.
Después de controlar la mente, después de controlar los sentidos, viene la discriminación entre el espíritu y la materia.
The discrimination.
Discriminación entre espíritu y materia.
Yes, yes. Because this is not a theoretical idea.
Porque no es una idea teórica.
You can say it many times, I am not this body, I am not this body, you are not this body.
Puedes repetirte muchas veces, no soy este cuerpo, no soy cuerpo.
But did you experience that you are not the body?
Pero experimentar que no eres este cuerpo.
Then it's just empty words.
Son palabras vacías.
Only the experience will come when the mind and senses have become completely pacified, peaceful.
Solamente esta experiencia vendrá cuando tu mente y tus sentidos están completamente pacíficos.
So he's saying, adhyatma lagna, avikaram abun manome. And my teacher brought me to this point where my mind was nirvikara. It was no longer oscillating. There were no modifications of the substance, the chitta.
Y mi maestro me llevó a este punto de no oscilación de la mente.
Que es nirvikam.
De que es nirvikam.
No hay ninguna contaminación sobre chitta.
No hay ninguna contaminación sobre
chitta. So, just like if you look on the surface of water, which is has waves, you cannot see your reflection. But if the water is completely still, then you can see yourself. So in the same way, when the mind becomes steady, then you can see your soul reflected there.
De la misma manera que cuando ves el agua y está moviéndose, no puedes ver el reflejo de tu ser. De la misma manera, si no se detienen las fluctuaciones de la mente, no puedes ver el reflejo de tu alma.
But still, you cannot see Krishna.
Y más aún todavía no puedes ver a Krishna.
To see Krishna needs two things. On one side, the purified mind, and on the other side, some kripa, mercy.
Ver a Krishna necesita o requiere dos requisitos. Uno es una mente pura y la otra es la misericordia.
So, the mercy comes through sadhu sangha, the association of saints.
Y la misericordia viene por la asociación con los santos, sadhu sangha.
Once there was a very great king.
Una vez existió un rey muy importante.
Millions of years ago.
Millones
in Satya Yuga.
In Satya Yuga.
His name was Uparichara Vasu.
Uparichara Vasu.
So he wanted to perform a big sacrifice.
Quería realizar un gran sacrificio.
Ashvamedha yagya. So he called all the great sages of the universe to come and officiate in this sacrifice.
Invitó a todos los sabios de todos los mundos, todos los grandes santos de todos los mundos, a celebrar
esa
oficiar el sacrificio.
So The main officiating priest of the sacrifice was Brihaspati, the guru of the devatas.
El jefe principal fue
Brihaspati, es el guru de
los semidioses.
And other great sages like Kanva Rishi, they were present.
Y otros grandes sabios como Kanva Rishi, pues estaba presente.
And also the great sages known as Ekata, Dvita and Trita, their sons of Brahma.
Y también los hijos de Brahma.
So all these sages were there.
Todos los sabios estaban.
And they were performing the sacrifice, and Brihaspati was making oblations into the fire and chanting the mantras.
Y Brihaspati estaba haciendo oblaciones y cantando mantras.
Om Indraya Swaha. Swaha. And Indra, the king of heaven, would appear from the fire and accept his offering and then disappear.
Indra, el rey de los cielos,
apareció, aceptó su parte de la ofrenda y se marcha.
Om Surya Devaya Swaha.
Swaha.
Om Chandaya Swaha. So they were making. He was making the oblations in the fire, and all the devatas were coming from the fire, accepting their offerings and leaving.
Todos los devatas ofrecían sus
aparecían en el fuego, aceptaban sus ofrendas y se marchaban.
And everyone there could see them.
Todo el mundo allí podía verlos.
Everyone saw them. So then, Brihaspati said. Om Narayanaya Swaha.
Swaha.
And what happened?
¿Y qué ocurrió?
No one saw anything. Oh.
Nadie vio nada.
Except for the king Uparicharavasu. He saw that God, not the angels, but God himself appeared from the fire.
El rey sí fue el único que vio a Dios.
And he accepted the offering of Uparicharavasu and disappeared.
Aceptó la ofrenda de Uparicharavasu.
Uparicharavasu.
Y desapareció.
So then, the king, he was in ecstasy.
El rey estaba en éxtasis.
Because he had the darshan, the vision of God.
Porque tenía la visión de Dios.
And all the other sages there, they think he is very lucky.
Y todos los demás sabios decían, oh, tiene mucha suerte.
He must have received some blessing.
Debe haber recibido alguna bendición.
From some great saint.
De algún gran santo.
So Brihaspati, he was so upset. I am the priest of this sacrifice.
Brihaspati estaba muy enfadado porque dijo, yo soy el sacerdote de este sacrificio.
Why I couldn't see God?
¿Por qué no he podido ver a Dios?
This king has seen him. Why I couldn't see him?
Porque este rey lo ha visto y yo no he podido verlo.
So then his sacrificial ladle, the shrook, it's called the sacrificial ladle, he threw it in the air. In
anger. Tiró al aire el cucharón del sacrificio.
In anger.
Con ira.
And he was so angry. Tears were coming in his eyes.
Estaba tan enfadado que se le saltaban las lágrimas de los ojos.
So then Ekata,
entonces,
one of the rishis came to him and said, oh, don't be upset.
Uno de los rishis dijo, oh, no te preocupes.
Don't be angry.
No te enfades.
Because this is the Satyug.
Porque esto es Satyug todavía.
So no one is angry yet. That's coming
todavía.
Later in the other.
No puedes enfadarte, eso pertenece a otras edades.
So it's not appropriate.
No es adecuado. Que te enfades.
Listen, I want to tell you something from my own experience.
Quiero contarte algo de mi propia experiencia.
Many years ago, along with my brothers,
hace muchos años, junto con mis hermanos,
we were doing intense yoga sadhana.
Estábamos haciendo un sadhana intenso.
We were like this, standing on one leg.
Estábamos de pie en una, sobre una pierna.
And remembering mantra, praying. For about 1,000 years.
Durante 1,000 años.
Fasting.
Ayunábamos.
We did extreme austerities.
que hacíamos austeridades muy extremas.
And then at the end of our vow,
y al final de nuestro voto,
then we took our sacrificial bath.
Nos dimos un baño sacrificio.
When you finish a vow, then in the end you have to take a bath in a holy place called Avabritasnan.
Cuando haces un sacrificio, después te tienes que bañar en un lugar.
So when we did our snan, then we heard a voice in the sky.
Y entonces oyeron una voz en el cielo.
It said,
decía,
I am very pleased with you.
Estoy muy contento contigo.
So I am giving you a personal instruction.
Te voy a dar una instrucción personal.
You should go to the west.
Deberías ir al oeste.
And traveling, you will come to a place called Sweta Dweep.
Y cuando viajes, te encontrarás un lugar que se llama Sweta
Dweep. It means a white island.
Que significa la isla blanca.
And all the inhabitants of that place, their complexion is completely white.
Y los habitantes de ese lugar tienen una tez completamente blanca.
Their minds are pure.
Sus mentes son puras.
They are always, hands are always praying.
Sus manos siempre se encuentran
in this posture of praying.
En la posición de rezar.
So, if you want to see me,
si quieres verme,
you should go there.
Deberías ir allí.
So then they thought, oh, this is wonderful. So we did not see God from our long austerities, but we know now where to go to see him.
Entonces se dijeron, esto es maravilloso. Ahora ya sabemos a dónde podemos ir para verlo. Adiós.
And we know where there are some persons who can see him.
Y sabemos que hay unas personas que pueden ver a Dios.
So they traveled, they followed his guidance, the instructions, to travel to in the western direction, and they came to a place called Sweta Dweep.
Y viajaron, fueron hacia el oeste y fueron a este lugar llamado Sweta Dweep, la isla blanca.
It was not like now.
No era como es ahora. Que se han apagado las luces.
Estaba lleno de luz.
Estaba lleno de luz.
Everywhere, this place was so illuminated with light they could hardly see.
Estaba tan iluminado de luz, tan lleno de luz que apenas se podía ver.
And they were trying to look around, but they could not see anyone living there.
Miraron a todas partes, pero no podían ver a nadie que viviera allí.
So then, Ekata, he said, that myself and the other sages, suddenly we had a realization.
Ekata y los otros sabios dijeron, en algún lado hay una, podemos ver esta realidad.
We're in the right place.
Estamos en el lugar adecuado.
But,
pero,
and these beings are here, but we are not pure enough, we cannot see them.
Y estos seres están aquí, pero no los vemos porque no somos suficientemente puros.
That means, in his humility, he understood what to speak about seeing God. We are not even qualified to see the persons who can see him.
Por su humildad, vieron que ellos no podían ver a esos seres, mucho menos podían ver a Dios, porque no eran puros.
So then they thought, we should do more prayer and austerity.
Dijeron, vamos a hacer más austeridades y más rezos.
So they began to meditate again for 100 years.
Empezaron a meditar otros 100 años.
And then after 100 years they opened their eyes.
Y tras 100 años abrieron los ojos.
And they could see so many beautiful beings were there.
Y vieron muchos bellos seres.
They were completely white and their cloth was completely white.
La tez completamente blanca y el vestido.
They were always in ecstasy. Even their eyes were not blinking.
Siempre en éxtasis se encontraban estos seres y incluso no lo cerraban los ojos.
Wherever they went, they were like this.
Ellos iban de un lado a otro con esa expresión.
So they saw that all of these beings were going somewhere. They began to go in one direction.
Ellos se dieron cuenta de que todos estos seres iban hacia un lugar. En la misma dirección.
And they gathered in a circle, and they could hear the sound of bells ringing, and they could smell the incense, the smoke of incense.
Se reunieron en un lugar, en un círculo, y podían escuchar unas campanas que sonaban y el olor del incienso.
And they could hear mantras.
Y oyeron mantras.
idamasanam avayami stapami prabhusi kripaya swagatam kuru. Like they could hear that actually these beings that come together in a crowd, and in the middle they were doing one puja according to Pancharatra, a ritual of worship following the Pancharatra.
Estaban reunidos en un círculo y estaban haciendo una ceremonia de Pancharatra.
De acuerdo con el Pancharatra.
Suddenly they heard they were all chanting Jai Jai.
De repente todos cantaban Jai Jai.
Rishikesh ki
Jai.
Adi Purush ki
Jai.
Purushottama ki
Jai.
Narayana ki
Jai.
And they were chanting the names of God. And as they were, yes.
Y estaban cantando los nombres de Dios.
As they were chanting, then such a breeze was blowing from that arena, and those sages who were in the distance, they could smell. This breeze is not even from this world.
Cuando estaban allí, vieron un viento suave que y fragante que llegaba hasta ellos desde la arena.
Y decían esta fragancia no viene de este mundo.
Esta fragancia no viene de este mundo.
It seemed like a mixture of the fragrance of sandalwood paste.
Una mezcla de pasta de sándalo.
With aguru.
Con aguru.
And camphor.
Y camphor.
And vermilion.
Vermilion.
Coco.
Vermilion.
Yeah. And also the fragrance of tulsi.
Y la fragancia de tulsi.
So you can just guess who it was there in the middle of the. So then after some time, then that breeze that was carrying that fragrance, it stopped and the fragrance disappeared.
Al cabo de un tiempo, esa brisa que llegaba, desapareció.
Then all those personalities, they turned around from that puja and they began to walk home.
Todas esas personalidades se marcharon del lugar de la puja y volvieron a casa. Con la boca abierta.
Ekata and those rishis saw that those persons, that they were just going home, they were smiling, they were very cheerful, but they did not even look upon us.
Esos seres,
they didn't notice us, they just walked past us.
Esos seres que iban en trance hacia sus casas no cayeron en la cuenta de la existencia de estos.
De estos
no
los vieron antes. Y pasaron
it, was as, it was as if we were not even there.
Como si no estuvieran allí.
And then they went away.
Y después se marcharon.
So then, the Ekata and the Rishis, they heard a voice.
Ekata y los Rishis escucharon una voz.
He said, still you cannot see me.
Todavía no me puedes ver.
Until you get the glance from those beings.
Hasta que puedas echar
obtener la gracia.
Obtener una vista de esos seres.
Hasta so, after so many years, they had developed the mental control. They understood their own spirit. But still they could not see God because mercy is necessary, and that mercy comes from the loving glance of the saints.
Esto no podían ver a Krishna porque no habían recibido la misericordia de la mirada de esos seres brillantes sobre ellos.
So Raghunath Das Goswami is saying that rupasya tatsmitamukam sadaya lokam sadya madhyati harascharita idanim. First my guru, he made my mind peaceful so that I could understand that I was a soul. And then after that, by his glance and by his smile, he made my heart mad for the sweetness of Krishna's pastimes.
Mi maestro Raghunatha dijo, me dio la oportunidad de acallar mi mente y también, gracias a su mirada puesta en mi corazón.
So first,
acallar la mente y luego recibir la misericordia de su mirada.
And then, yes, by his smile and by his glance.
Por su mirada y por su sonrisa.
A través de su mirada y su sonrisa despertó en mí.
Despertó en mí.
La visión para poder.
La visión para poder.
So, Because of the mercy of Rupa Goswami, when Raghunath Das Goswami was chanting Hare Krishna, then he used to go into samadhi, into trance, and see the loving pastimes of Krishna.
Que después de la misericordia Raghunatha Das Goswami,
Rupa
Goswami,
que le dio a Raghunatha Das Goswami, Raghunatha Das Goswami pudo tener esa visión después de tiempos de Krishna.
Everyone can hear?
No.
Then tell loudly so everyone can hear.
Que lo digas más alto.
Ah. Que gracias a la misericordia de Rupa Goswami, Raghunatha Das Goswami pudo recibir. Gracias a la visión de Rupa Goswami, Raghunatha Das Goswami pudo recibir la misericordia a través de su vida. Cantando más.
So he said, Alinganena sirasa parichumbanena snehabarena avalokana kanjanakshi brajeshaya navavidum ivalalamanam.
Dijo,
oh, when will that day come?
¿Cuándo vendrá ese día?
When I will have a spiritual form,
que tenga esa forma espiritual,
and be a maid servant,
y sea una sirvienta,
of the goddess of love, Sirada,
de la diosa del amor, Sirada.
In the morning, when will I take her?
Por la mañana.
To the palace of Nanda Maharaj.
Cuando la llevaré al palacio de Nanda Maharaj.
Where Krishna lives.
Donde vive Krishna.
And as we are approaching that place, Nandagam.
Y cuando nos aproximamos a ese lugar, Nandagam.
We can hear so many brahmanas are chanting mantras of the Vedas.
Escuchamos a los brahmanas cantando los Vedas.
And cows are mooing.
Y los las vacas están mugiendo.
And their bells are chiming.
Y las campanas suenan.
And it seems like the whole village is in a state of a festival.
Y parece como si todo el pueblo estuviese de festival.
Oh, when we approach the palace of Nanda Maharaj.
Cuando llegaremos al palacio de Nanda Maharaj.
Then Yashoda.
Entonces,
Krishna's mother will come out.
La madre de Krishna saldrá.
And greet Radharani.
Y saludará y recibirá saludando a Radharani.
Srimati Radhika.
Srimati Radhika.
Along with her friends and myself, we'll all bow down to your shoulder.
Junto con sus amigas y yo misma, nos inclinaremos ante Madre Yashoda.
And Madre Yashoda will embrace Radhika so lovingly.
Madre Yashoda abrazará muy amorosamente
a Radhika. And kiss her all over her face.
Y le besará por toda la cara.
As if Navavidum Ivalalamanam means that Yashoda is showing so much love to Radha as if she were her own daughter-in-law.
Y le está mostrando tanto amor como si fuese realmente su nuera.
So that makes Radhika very nervous in public.
Eso le pone muy nerviosa a Radhika en público.
Sneha Bharena Avalokana Kanjanakshi. So then Radharani's eyes become like a kanjan. That means whitetail birds. What is everyone thinking?
Los ojos de Radhika se vuelven muy parpadeantes y mirando a un lado y a otro, avergonzados.
When will I see this festival of bliss?
¿Cuándo veré este festival de bendición?
And then I will go to the kitchen with Radhika.
Y luego iré a la cocina con Radhika.
Before she enters the kitchen, I'll remove. She has so many decorations, ornaments. So it's too many ornaments to do any service in the kitchen. So some of the heavier ones we'll remove, and in a more abridged version of her decorations, she'll go into the kitchen.
Yeah. Antes de entrar en la cocina, yo le quitaré parte de las joyas que recubren su cuerpo, porque va cubierta de muchas joyas, y para entrar en la cocina y cocinar, hay que llevar menos decoración.
And very soon with her sakis, she'll make so many delicious preparations for Sri Krishna.
Y pronto ella con las Radhika con las sakis prepararán deliciosos platos para Krishna.
And then Krishna will come to the dining room and sit down with Balaram and Madhu Mangal.
Krishna llegará al salón y se pondrá a comer con sus amigos.
And with other friends.
Mm-hmm.
And very happily they start to take their
empezarán a tomar
morning meal.
empezarán a tomar su desayuno.
At that time, Mother Yashoda tells Radhika, "Oh, go and serve these puris."
Entonces Madre Yashoda le dirá a Radhika, "Vete a servir estos puris."
And Radhika is very nervous.
Radhika se siente muy nerviosa, está muy nerviosa.
So she comes to the line and she's giving a puri here, a puri there, and getting closer and closer to Krishna.
Y va poniendo, va ofreciendo los pudins, cada vez acercándose un poquito más a Krishna.
But when she gets close to Krishna, her hands are shaking so much she drops the whole tray on the ground.
Pero cuando se pone al lado de Krishna, está tan nerviosa que se le cae el plato de las manos.
And quickly runs to the kitchen.
Y se echa a correr para la cocina.
Srila Raghunath Das Goswami is chanting, "Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Rama Hare Hare."
And in his trance, he's seeing the beautiful exchanges of love of Radha and Krishna in the spiritual world.
En su trance ve los intercambios amorosos entre Radha y Krishna.
En el mundo espiritual.
From a balcony, Radharani is looking through lattice window and watching Krishna eating.
Desde una celosía, Radha ve a Krishna que está comiendo.
Espía a Krishna como él está comiendo.
So this is very beautiful. If a wife is cooking for a husband and then she feeds him and he's eating, then she relishes so much that he's relishing.
Cuando una mujer cocina para su marido, ella siente tanto placer como el placer que siente su marido al comer el alimento.
Actually, you, when you cook, your consciousness goes in the food.
De hecho, tu conciencia se transmite al alimento.
And then the person who eats it, then their body becomes made now of your consciousness.
Y cuando tomas el alimento, también te impregna de la conciencia de la persona que ha preparado el alimento.
So cooking is a very, very intimate service of love.
Cocinar es un servicio de amoroso muy, muy íntimo.
So all the love of Radhika is going into these preparations and Krishna's tasting the love.
Todo el amor de Radhika ha impregnado esas preparaciones y Krishna está saboreando ese amor.
But she's not his wife, so she cannot stand there and watch.
Pero ella no es su esposa, por eso
and relish that.
No
but from a balcony and looking through a lattice window, she's looking.
No se le permite estar allí y mira desde la escondida, desde detrás de la celosía.
Como él
se
saborea. This is called parakiya rasa.
Y eso se llama parakiya rasa.
So, when will I be there, not looking at Krishna, relishing, looking at Radhika, how Radhika is relishing that Krishna is relishing.
¿Cuándo llegará el tiempo en que yo pueda ver a Radhika sintiendo placer?
Espiar a Radhika,
que está espiando a su vez a Krishna y que está disfrutando con ese alimento.
So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught us, Gopi Bhakti Patkamalyo Dasa Dasa Anudasa. I am the servant of the servant of the servant of the Gopinath Krishna.
Yo soy el sirviente del sirviente del sirviente de Gopinath Krishna.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught us.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu nos ha dicho.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu nos ha dicho, seamos el sirviente del sirviente del sirviente.
Chaitanya.
Then, Radharani has made one very beautiful sweet called the Manohar Ladu.
Radharani ha preparado un dulce llamado...
And she's waiting. Oh, I have made this very special preparation. How will Krishna like it?
He hecho esta preparación. ¿Cómo le gustará a Krishna?
So, Krishna, he knows that she's watching.
Krishna sabe que ella está mirando.
So he picked it up and...
y pone cara de asco.
And threw it down.
Y lo tira.
The moment is so beautiful.
En ese momento es muy bello.
Because Mother Yashoda was watching.
Ese momento es muy bello porque Madre Yashoda está mirando.
She became upset.
Y se enfada.
Is someone trying to poison my son?
Es que alguien está intentando envenenar a mi hijo.
Balaram is there. Balaram is just laughing.
Balaram está riendo.
Because he knows Krishna is very tricky.
Pero sabe que porque sabe que Krishna es muy gamberro.
And he's just pretending.
Y que está fingiendo.
Chandravali is nearby watching also.
Chandravali también está cerca de allí mirando.
And she's yes.
Y ella
she's very happy.
Muy contenta.
Porque es la rival.
Porque es la rival de Radharani.
Because her rival, Radha, has cooked something that he doesn't like.
Porque es su rival.
So she's very happy.
Porque su rival Radharani ha preparado algo que a él, a Krishna no le gusta, y entonces está muy contento.
Radhika is in great distress. Oh, what did I? Maybe I put in the wrong ingredient.
Radhika está muy triste. Es que me equivoqué al poner los ingredientes.
Se pregunta, ¿me he equivocado al poner algún ingrediente?
Sometimes you may mix up the salt and sugar. Looks the same.
Algunas veces la sal y el azúcar parecen iguales.
So in this way. Oh, Krishna is playing a joke, Balaram is laughing, Madhya Chaudhary is angry, and Chandravali is celebrating, Radharani is angry, like this, all the various rasas are there, but Krishna is in the center of
De esta forma,
so, Rasa Vaisa.
De esta forma, Krishna se está fingiendo, se está riendo, Balaram también se está riendo, su rival, la rival de Radharani está muy contenta porque cree que ha hecho algo. Ha triunfado y si Mati Radharani en cambio está muy triste y Madre Yasoda está preocupada. ¿Eh?
Entonces alrededor todos, de Krishna se producen un montón de emociones que se llaman de ese
instante.
So the Vedas say Rasa Vaisa, the absolute truth, is the embodiment of all different flavors of love. Entonces, simultaneously, at the same time.
Rasa Vaisa dice que Krishna es la encarnación de todos los rasas, de todos los sabores.
The Vedas say that the absolute truth is the embodiment of all flavors of love.
La verdad dicen que la verdad absoluta es la encarnación de todos los rasas.
De todos los sabores
del amor. So then Radhika thinks, I have to find out what mistake I made.
Radhika piensa, tengo que averiguar qué error he cometido.
So she got a servant to bring it to her. She tasted. It was perfect.
Una sirvienta que le acerque el alimento y lo prueba y dice, esto está perfecto.
So she threw it down.
Lo tira.
That cunning person.
Es una persona astuta.
And then Krishna came and then he picked it up.
Luego viene Krishna y lo coge.
Then he ate. Why? Because there was a missing ingredient that he wanted to taste. That it should be Radhika's remnants.
Porque había, porque quería probar los remanentes de Radhika.
Había un ingrediente secreto
que faltaba en el anterior, que eran los remanentes de Radhika.
This is an ingredient that she herself voluntarily. She will not put that ingredient. So Krishna, by a trick, made this ingredient present.
En lo anterior, Radhika no había puesto ese ingrediente extra secreto por voluntad propia, pero Krishna, mediante un truco, consigue que Radhika ponga ese ingrediente para saborear.
In essence, what we are saying today is, as long as the mind is the oscillating, and there is bodily identification, then you will not be able to taste the sweetness of the beautiful pastimes of Krishna.
Mientras tu mente siga oscilando, estés puro, no puede.
Tú vas a identificar con el cuerpo.
Te vas a identificar con el cuerpo y va a ser imposible que puedas saborear los pasatiempos de Krishna.
But if your mind is peaceful and you are free from bodily identification, then still you cannot taste the sweetness of Krishna.
Aunque tu mente esté estable y tu
sentidos pacíficos, aún así todavía no podrás. Es probable que no puedas.
Es probable que no puedas ver los pasatiempos de Krishna.
And when we receive the merciful glance of a Gurudev and pure saints, the heart becomes filled with the nectar. And we can experience how sweet are the loving pastimes of Krishna.
al mirar a nuestro...
Pero cuando tú ya recibas la mirada de los santos y del Guru...
Cuando recibas la mirada de los santos y del Guru, es, en tu corazón podrás ver...
Podrás apreciar la dulzura.
Podrás apreciar la dulzura
de
los pasatiempos de Cristo.
Vale, vendaban de ailar aquí. Yeah.